favorites to beat the Orange in their NCAA tournament opener against Syracuse. Former San Diego Clipper and college basketball analyst Jim Brogan has seen more basketball than the rest of us combined. Jim, kind enough to offer his insight as to how things might play out Friday. Mr. Brogan, thank you for making time available to us on a Tuesday.
Great to see you, Paul. It's not in the studio, so here at the house, but it's an exciting time, as you know, March Madness, one full month of basketball. Even for the non-basketball enthusiast, this does tend to galvanize people, and, you know, they always have the office pools, so I'm curious to see how they're going to do it this year. You know, the Zoom pools, I guess, is what we're going to have.
Yeah, yeah. The brackets will be down a little bit, but eventually, or at least we're going to have a tournament, so we got to, you know, baby steps, right?
You bet. I mean, from what happened last year when they were starting the tournament, and unfortunately all those young men and young women across the country didn't get to participate in one of the greatest times of their life, something they always looked forward to. This year they figured out a way, the NCAA, to be able to do this, put it in one place so that they can mitigate what would happen as far as the pandemic is concerned. But great to see SDSU back in there after an incredible year last year, having a one seed. And now here they are, back in it, so they have a chance to maybe do it again.
All right, so let's get right to it. Time is tight, so let's. I want to start with Dutcher. I mean, remember when we were worried that, he's not going to be able to replace a legend. He's done that and more, has he not?
Unbelievable. 53-6 in the last 2 years. And, you know, when they first came here, Steve and Brian Dutcher, they wanted to make this a program. And now it's so big that it's become a destination point for, you've seen now these college portals where people can transfer from one school to another school. And that's what SDSU has become. And Brian Dutcher and his staff has made this a basketball powerhouse that it's recognized across the country. And you can see by the results in the record.
So how worried are you that the Gophers now have a vacancy? We all know about the clause in his deal. Patino, I think, is going to go to New Mexico, so his time on the unemployment line will be short. But the Gophers are looking for a coach, and Dutcher's on every list that I see in Minnesota media outlets.
Yeah, it's a great question. Unfortunately, when you get results, people look for you. And college basketball, college football, all colleges across the country look for people that can get results because it does make a big difference to their base, to their donorship. And Brian Dutcher's proven that. So, and he's from that area. He's been there. So I think SDSU might have to step up and say, look, we want to keep you here because they fill that arena. I mean, right. You could fill that arena 20 times a year, sold out. That's a big deal to your campus, to your community, and to
Absolutely.
The alumni.
All right, let's talk about his counterpart, Jimmy Boeheim. It's almost a religion with him, that 2-3 zone. how do the Aztecs match up against that kind of defense, and is that something that's going to be problematic for them?
It might be a bit of a challenge. You know, he's been doing that for 40 years, and he recruits people that can play long, meaning the long arms. They don't have to be extremely tall because they move in one unit. If you watch it very closely, they move together, which is very, very difficult for an offense who hasn't played against a lot. And San Diego State only really plays against the zone one time, maybe two times a year against the Air Force Academy. So this is going to be a challenge that San Diego State does not rely on just putting up three-pointers. Penetrate into the seams, maybe kick out, get the ball into the center of the court, meaning somewhere around the foul line, they need to get the ball and then distribute it from there. And use Mensa, if he can, use his long arms, use his long length that he can get offensive rebounds and putbacks.
All right, so after they win Friday...
I like that. I agree with you. I see it happening.
They're going to shoot them out of that zone. I mean, it's good. So then what happens Sunday? I assume that Mountaineer is on the horizon, right?
Bobby Huggins, you know, I've known him. I've played against the Mountaineers when I was in college, and they're always a pressure-type defense. They want to try to wear out the point guard as much as they possibly can. It's 40 minutes of nonstop in your face. They would definitely have their hands full. West Virginia University this year is extremely athletic, but they first have to get through Syracuse and this 2-3 zone that can be bothersome to the Aztecs.
All right, so in your viewpoint, or as we're looking at, I believe West Virginia take on, I don't know who that was. Was that Oklahoma State, I think? All right, Jimmy, just quickly, who's going to win the game? Are you that the Aztecs are going to win Friday, aren't they?
I think Aztecs will win. The only time they've lost is when they've been under 65 points, only one time when they're above 65 points. So the games that they lost, they've got to get the ball out on the break if possible. Take advantage of their defensive prowess. They are very good defensively. I mean, one thing, if you're going to play for San Diego State and Brian Dutcher, you've got to be able to play defense. And I think if they can score on that, and if you look at their ratio to turnovers, they're a plus four on all their games this year. So they have an advantage right there, meaning that, hey, let's get the ball. We get the turnovers, push it down the floor. Don't give Syracuse the opportunity to set up in that 2-3 zone.
All right, so then that will make an availability for you and I to chat again next week on the week two of the tournament, okay?
I look forward to the Aztecs going 2-0 this weekend.
Jim Brogan, thank you very much for if anything, even if they lose, we'll have you back just to recap and the path forward, okay?
Look forward to it, Paul. Have a great day.
All right, Jim. Thank you very much.